sources of water. Friends, in our previous session, we had studied about the hydrological cycle or water cycle. If you remember, we had said that evapotranspiration, condensation, and precipitation are the three main parts of water cycle, where precipitation happens to be the main source of water for the earth. This rain and snow that falls on the earth either ends up as surface runoff and infiltration. But what exactly is surface runoff? It is the water that flows off to various water bodies on the land to form surface water. The examples of surface water includes seas, oceans, rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. It can be saline water or fresh water. These surface waters are naturally replenished through precipitation and lost through evaporation, and also some amount of water seeps into the ground. Having understood how surface water is formed, let's see the process of percolation or infiltration. Some amount of rainwater also seeps down or percolates into the ground. As the water moves down, the soil particles or the spaces between the soils are full of water. This level of ground saturation is called as water table. The water that is found there is called groundwater. The rock structure that holds this groundwater is called as an aquifer. Friends, have you seen a sponge? It has many tiny pores in it, and the water that it soaks is stored in these spaces. An aquifer resembles a sponge in natural conditions. Before we move ahead, a question popped in my mind. Is groundwater fresh water or saline water? Yes, it is a freshwater source and makes up to 30% of the world's freshwater supply. Because of it being a freshwater source, some people picture groundwater as an underground river or lake. So here we can say that precipitation is the main source of water, which is available to us in the forms of surface water and groundwater. We can satisfy our various needs like drinking, washing, cleaning, cooking, or other uses like irrigation, industrial use, transportation, fisheries, energy generation, etc. from these fresh water as well as marine water sources. Well, let's proceed and see how precipitation, that is, rainwater or snow, which is the main source of water for the whole earth, is allocated or distributed, considering example of India. India receives precipitation in the form of rainfall from the monsoon winds and the snow from the Himalayan mountain ranges. This rain and snow is finally available to us in the form of surface and groundwater. Surface water sources in India includes a large network of rivers like Himalayan rivers, rivers of Deccan Plateau, coastal rivers and inland drainage basins. All these are sources of fresh water. India also forms a peninsula to its south, as it is surrounded on three sides by seas, which contributes to the marine water sources of the country. Talking about the groundwater sources, India does not have a large continuous aquifers, but the coastal plains, the low-lying areas of mountain valleys, are rich source of groundwater. So we have seen how India is blessed with all types of water sources. But friends, if we observe, there are certain factors that directly or indirectly influence water distribution, like location of a country, its climate, the physical structures like mountains, plateaus, plains, deserts, etc. Or in other words, topography, the structure of rocks or aquifers, and also a country's proximity or nearness to the sea. And these factors vary from place to place. Like for example, if we consider Saudi Arabia, a country located in the Middle East. Owing to its hot and dry climate, it receives very little or infrequent rainfall. Therefore, it has no permanent rivers or lakes and has a very few natural aquifers. What then is their main source of water? Well, because of the proximity to the sea, 50% of the drinking water is obtained by desalination procedures. Although being an oil-rich country, it is water poor. Friends, these are a few factors which influences the water distribution throughout the globe, thus making a country water rich or water poor. Hence, we can conclude the water distribution throughout the globe is uneven. That means certain areas have a large natural supply of water, whereas some areas have scarce water resources. There are certain places in the world where people do not have access to clean drinking water. We hear cases where people walk miles just to find a water source. There are places where people lose their agricultural crops because it didn't rain the entire year. Water is the foundation of life, but water scarcity is a nightmare in many parts around the world. To know the factors that are causing this shortage or scarcity of water, do tune in to our next session, where we'll be seeing the various ways by which we can conserve water. We never know the worth of water till the well is dry. Well, that's it for today. If you have liked our session, please hit the like button. If you have any queries, write it in the comment box below. Do subscribe to our channel, and till we meet the next time, keep watching and keep learning. Thank you.